Quantum computing and biology. Quantum computing is a research area in rapid progress that is receiving a lot of interest from pharmaceutical companies. However, it's also a really tricky topic to cover, and this video has taken me way too long to prepare. Most existing material, especially here on YouTube, either falls into the camp of popular science that is too shallow and overly optimistic, or it's lectures from advanced courses in computer science that cover a lot of heavy linear algebra and give few, if any, use cases. There are some good videos though, and for that reason, I have a linked playlist at the end. Here, I'll cover how quantum computing can lead to dramatic speedups, but also give a realistic view of what this means, if anything, for biological data science, or if it is just hype. Quantum computing works very different from a traditional computer, which has bits that are either 0 or 1. A quantum computer instead has quantum bits, known as qubits, which are a superpositioning of a 0 state and a 1 state. That is, each qubit is simultaneously 0 and 1. An easier way to think of this is that it has a probability of being 1. That on its own is pretty useless. However, when you have quantum entanglement, you now have coupling between the qubits, which means that you have conditional probabilities. That allows n entangled qubits to model the probability distribution over 2 to the n states, and a single quantum operation can modify the distribution of 2 to the n probabilities in one operation. That is what allows you to get an exponential speedup by using a quantum computer. However, that's only the case for specific problems. Quantum algorithms can be very powerful when you have a combinatorial explosion and need to find either the solution to an equation or the global optimum of some function. I'll quickly mention two of the most famous algorithms. The first is quantum phase estimation, which can be used to solve the Schrödinger equation and has direct applications in quantum chemistry. And it is the core Shor's algorithm to prime factorization, which is very important in cryptography. In both cases, it provides an exponential speedup, but it's important to realize that this is a very narrow class of problems. Arguably more interesting is Grover's algorithm. It can be used for binary optimization and graph-related problems, and it's applicable to a very broad class of problems. The downside is that it only gives a quadratic speedup, not an exponential speedup. However, the biggest problem with quantum computing is that while the algorithms are ready, quantum computers are not. So far, they have too few qubits to be really applicable to real-world problems. Quantum simulation is one of the more promising areas for quantum computing. Because a quantum computer can solve the Schrödinger equation, you can think of it as a configurable quantum system that you can use to simulate any other system. A very big near-term opportunity is therefore to use it in quantum chemistry. This will allow you to simulate reactions, which could have a lot of impact in terms of designing better catalysts. It's tempting to think that we could do the same in quantum biology, and that way easily design better drugs. However, that is definitely not a near-term opportunity. The reason is that biological systems, such as proteins, generally consist of many thousand atoms, which will require many qubits to simulate on a quantum computer, and we are very far from having such big quantum computers. Quantum machine learning is another possible application of quantum computers. When you do machine learning, you're training a model, which is ultimately an optimization problem in which you try to minimize a loss function, which is the kind of problem that a quantum computer would be very good at. However, research is at a very early stage. So far, people are mainly working on technical challenges related to how to do quantum data encoding, since to do machine learning, we need to pack many data points into the few qubits that we will have on a quantum computer. Within data science, though, I think the bigger issue is that data is what matters most, not the optimization. If you have bad data, you're going to get a bad model no matter what you do. Quantum is not some sort of magic that turns bad data into good data. And that brings me to the problem of quantum hype. You will hear people throw around terms like quantum artificial intelligence and quantum supremacy in an attempt to attract large investments, primarily based on the fear of missing out. It is to some extent legitimate FOMO though. We do stand in front of a potential quantum revolution, just like we are currently in an actual AI revolution. And if you're a pharmaceutical company, I can see why you would want to invest some amount of money in quantum computing to have it as a form of insurance policy in case it actually works. However, quantum computers will never replace normal traditional computers. It's going to be a specialized accelerator, just like we have specialized AI hardware that makes a huge difference for very specific problems. And that's all I have to say about quantum computing for now. If you want to learn more, I've linked a playlist here. I hope you'll enjoy it, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.